introduce to you the Honorable Governor of the State of Ohio, John Casey.
Wow, what a group, huh? You were probably expecting Justin Bieber, but he didn't make it today. He sent me in his place. Or One Direction, right? Listen, it's great to be here today, and what a wonderful welcome you gave me. So, I want to let you all know that I have twin daughters who are 14 years old. So, I'm for young women getting all the important jobs in America as a result of that, okay? Are you with me on that? Tell you a couple things I want you to think about before we sign this bill. Never, ever, ever step aside for a boy. Okay? And I don't care what anybody tells you, you can be whatever it is you want to be, and never let anybody talk you out of it. Now let me tell you another thing that I want you all to think about. Every single person, every one of you that's in this room is special. Let me see if I can get you to understand what I'm telling you. Every single person in this room was made special with a special set of gifts that no one else has. No one. Do we have a handheld mic? This is all I have. I'm chained down here. How do I do that? Do you know how to do that? How do I get it down here? Okay, so let me just tell you that this is what I have to believe, okay? Everybody doesn't think the way that I think, but I want to tell you how I think. I believe that every person was made special by the Lord with special gifts that make you unique. Now, when you know that, you know how that should make you feel? How does it make you feel if you actually knew that you were made special with special gifts that no one else had? How would that make you feel?
Really good.
You think maybe you believe that? Is that hard to believe? How many of you would believe you were made special with special gifts, huh? Because let me tell you, as you go through school, and what are we all, we're not all seniors, everybody here is a senior, okay? Is that right? Everybody's a senior? So next year, you're going to go off, I would assume almost all of you, to a chaotic and changing place, the community college or the four-year school. And you're going to see a lot of things. And sometimes it's going to get hard. And sometimes it's going to get confusing. And sometimes it's going to get frustrating. And sometimes you're going to say, is this really for me? The most important thing, well, there's so many important things to say, but one of the most important things to say when you have special gifts is they have to be developed. That's what studying is. That's what schoolwork is. It's about developing that brain so that you can fulfill your mission as a person on this earth. Because we were all made with special gifts to come together to form a giant mosaic. And our jobs as human beings are to make this place a little bit better, this world a little bit better. Nobody can just do it all because we're just one individual. Now, when we work together with other individuals and we come together as part of a team, we can really change things. Now, you might think, as you can see, I don't have any notes. I didn't come in here with a telephone. way that I see life. So in my lifetime, I've tried to figure out what it is that I'm supposed to do. And so you might say, Mr. Kasich, how do you do that? I know I have to sharpen my skills, that makes sense. My brain's got to be developed so I can carry out my mission, but how do you know what you're supposed to do? Anybody want to take a guess? Anybody want to tell me how you can figure it out? Huh? Yeah, how would you figure it out, Emily?
You try as many things as you can to witness.
That might be one way. How about you? Shoot an arrow and see where it lands. That's another good idea. Let me tell you how I think about it. If you search deeply inside of your soul, you'll get a sense of it. You will know if you trust your head and you trust your heart and you dig down, because it's getting into game time now. You're going to be 18, 19 years old, and you're either going to get out of high school, and then you're going to what am I going to do now? If you search down real deep, you will find that you'll get a real sense of what you were made to do. And then you have to go and do it. And you can't let anybody else talk you out of what it is that you think you should do. When I told my mother and father at a very early age that I thought I might go into politics, they couldn't figure out why I was saying it. They didn't even know what it really was. But I sort of knew it. And whenever I would go back home and I would have all these big plans and all these big dreams, the people that I grew up with, they couldn't see it. Because they kind of knew me too well. You know, they really couldn't see it. So, what I'm here to tell you is, never let anybody, try to talk you out of what you think you should do, what your hopes and your dreams and your purposes are. Because when you find your purpose, and when you use your gifts, and when you train yourself for the mission that you've been selected to perform, you're going to have a great life. You're going to experience great, great satisfaction in your life. Let me also tell you that you never want to handicap yourself. It really even bothers me to have to say this to you, but I'm going to tell you anyway. Never cave into those drugs. Never cave into the drugs. And let me tell you why I say it. The minute you get yourself addicted, the minute you get habits, it's like living in your house with an alligator that chases you around every day. And you have to feed the alligator. And if you don't feed the alligator, it'll come and it'll kill you. I promise you that you're going to be in a position now that you're going to be going to school where you're going to be exposed to it. Some of you may already have it. Don't go there. Don't be this fool. Don't let your peers talk you into it. I'm begging you. Because the minute you do it, might as well just tie up a 100-pound weight around your ankle. Stay away from it, because you've got too much to do in life. You've got too much fun to have. You've got too many things to explore, and you've got to find so much more out about yourself. Listen, if you're ever troubled. Anybody ever troubled in here? You know, you wonder who you are, and you wonder, are you good enough? Anybody here like that? Okay, let me tell you. Do you know what strength is? Do you know what courage is? Strength and courage is the ability to see your weaknesses. It's an ability to examine yourself and to say to yourself, okay, I got like a problem here. I'm going to going to go fix it. But in order to fix it, you have to be able to look at it. And sometimes people think that if I have a big problem and I keep it to myself, I'm going to be better. You're not. You're going to be better when you find somebody that you can trust and someone you can talk to and someone you can share the bothers you with. And when you do that, that's called strength. Now maybe that certain person is not going to be your mom or your dad or your grandfather or your grandmother. It might be your best friend's father or mother. I don't know. But real strength is being able to say, I've got some issues. I want to address them. And when you enter school here in the next year, sometimes it'll be a little confusing for you. Nothing wrong about coming home, calling home. Am I right, Dr. Ross? Address those issues and those problems. But you are all obviously talented because you're here. So you're like the best we have in Ohio. You're like the best we have. Did you think about that? I mean, do you know what it's like to be picked for Buckeye Girls State? I mean, this is like a big deal. Were you picked for that, Christina? She couldn't even make it, okay? She didn't make it. She's a state representative. Stand up. Let's have you see her, okay? She can't get this today. But everybody here, you're pretty darn good. And for the rest of your life, by the way, when you write a resume, guess what's going to be on there? Buckeye Girls State. So you take advantage of the things that you have accomplished. You know another thing you should be doing here? Make some friends. Make some friends who are not people that go to your school or live in your part of the state. Make some good friends. Stay in touch with them. Because you never know when that person can help you and you can help that person to climb up. Now my father was a mailman. I'm not even born and raised in Ohio. I'm from another state. And my father carried mail on his back for almost 30 years. His father was a coal miner. My mother's mother could barely speak English. And so, like many of you, no one ever handed me a single thing. I had to work to earn every single position or every single good thing that happened. I had to work for it. But why do I tell you that? I tell you not because I want you to go, oh, well, isn't he something? I want to tell you that because most of you are in the same position. Never doubt your ability to be the best. Never, ever doubt your ability to be what you have your heart set on. Because if you have confidence in yourself and never say no in your lifetime, it will be amazing what you will achieve. I also want to tell you that it is so important that we have young women involved in so many decisions, women period, because there is a point of view that never gets expressed if the woman is not in the room. My chief of staff, the lady in charge of my whole operation, is a woman named Beth. And I could not do this job effectively if I didn't have somebody like her around to give me a point of view that as a man I can't normally have or necessarily have. So we need more young women of excellence. We need more to seize that leadership ring and make a difference in the way the world works. A couple other things. Nobody here that I know of, especially me, is going to ever be sane. Because we're all flawed. We all have things that make us do things. We look back and say, why did we ever do that? But character. You know what character is? Do you know what character is, young lady? Huh? What do you think? Who wants to tell me what they think character is? Yes.
forms you into the person you're going to be.
What, who can tell me what good character is as opposed to bad character? Okay, who wants to try?
Good character is doing what's right even when nobody's watching.
And what's not good character? Doing something that isn't right, that we know is not right. Because values matter. And we're sort of back to drugs. Because if you cave, if you fall, you lower the bar. In your life, you want to raise the bar. So character, integrity, you know what it really gets down to? Make the world a little bit better place because you live in it. Love your neighbor as yourself. Never ignore that person who sometimes it's so easy to ignore. Be their friend. Because it will all accrue to your benefit. So a lot of this is like when I start this at home, my daughters always say, "Daddy, is this another lesson?" And I say, "Yes." And they say, "Do you think we need more lessons, Daddy?" I say, "Yes." But you can never hear the good guidance enough. And I hope this has all helped you a little bit today. But the most important thing I want you to think about when you leave here and you get home is I've been made special. Nobody's going to take that away from me. Nobody's going to put me down. Because I heard this guy say one time that I was special. And God made me special. And no one's going to take that away. And you keep that in mind. And it's going to serve you for your entire life, I promise you. Money guaranteed back if I'm not right. Okay? You'll have to find me out how you track me down, but you can try. So anyway, now you know what we're going to do? We're going to sign a bill. It's never happened at Girl State before. And this is an education bill. And I have some colleagues here from the legislature. Ms. Hagen, who you've met, Mr. Bremer, who's very involved in the stand-up, and your state senator, a dear friend of mine for many, many years, Scott Olschlager. He's a senator. He's a big shot, okay, big cheese. So, we also have with us the guy in charge of all education in K-12. He's with us today. His name is Dick Ross. He's the superintendent of all schools. And he's a very important guy. So now the members of the legislature, and you're all getting elected. Did you elect the governor yet? Okay, you haven't elected the governor yet. Okay. Well, you're going to elect the governor, probably the lieutenant governor, right? The secretary, all these offices, right? And then you're going to have a legislature. Now, when you're the governor, whether you like it or not, you have to get along with the legislature. Because if you have a great idea, if they don't think it's a great idea, you're not going to get it done. Because we're not like Putin and just decide what we want. We live in America. And so, yeah, we live in America. So, we had all these ideas and the things that we wanted to do. And let me tell you what a couple of them are. We had an idea that if you are in high school and you get to get your high school diploma, at the same time you're getting your high school diploma, you can also get credit at college. Now the reason why that's such a good idea is you save money. Now, let me just see if I can solve one thing here. I see these two young ladies taking my picture. So I'm coming out here because I just wonder if you want to take a selfie with me. Come on. Here we go. Go ahead. Come on. What does that mean? I want to be. What does that mean? Oh, yeah? Okay, well then maybe at the eight of you, we ought to have one more. Come on, right now. Let's go. That's faith, right here. Okay. All right, we'll have a big group. Big selfie group, okay? All right, come on, let's make it. Okay, do we have it? Okay. You know what we're going to do? I'm going to get that picture and send it to my daughters. They'll see that their daddy knows what's happening. So the first thing we were doing in this legislation is, again, we were giving you college prep. And then what we were saying, this is going to be for your brothers and sisters, or your neighbors, to be able to take vocational education in the seventh grade. Anybody in here been in vocational education? Raise your hands. Let me see. Fantastic, and that's going to grow. If we're going to make sure through vocational education, you can also go on to the two-year and the four-year school. And we are also going to make sure that we have a way of pulling our community together to be mentoring. Now, if you're here at Girl State, it's always good to be mentored. Believe me, it's always good. Because the people who do the mentoring are the people you go to and they can help you. But I want to tell you about something I learned down in Cincinnati. The Cincinnati public schools have a graduation rate of about 65%. That means 35% never get their high school diploma. So there's a school there that's part of the Cincinnati school system. And people from the business community go to the school and they spend an hour a week with a student for 1 year. The graduation rate in that school is 97%. Okay? So we want to spread that all over Ohio so that we all can be mentored and we can all get on our way. It's really important that we encourage one another. Now, for some of the students who are not here at Girl State, listen to this. It's pretty amazing. 24,000 young boys and girls don't graduate from high school every year in Ohio. Can you imagine that? You know how many that is, 24,000? We have 1 million people in Ohio who don't even have a high school diploma. Could you imagine what that would be like? It'd be pretty difficult. So we are going to have a different way for people who have no interest in school to be able to get a high school diploma. We're going to let them go out into businesses where they're going to learn about reading and writing and computing and arithmetic in a different way so we don't lose them. Because as we lose them, they could possibly lose those special gifts that they were given when they were born. And we don't want that to happen. So that and a number of other things are in this legislation. Now, I have a bunch of pens here. And I have the bill that I'm going to sign. We don't do anything with just a few pages. It's sort of like algebra 2. We do nothing to simple, okay? And I'm going to sign the date and my name, each letter separately signed with a pen. And then the pen, of course, becomes part of history, the signing of this bill. And I may then give these pens away. Now, we only have about a dozen of them. So I don't know how we're going to figure out who we're going to give them to. That's not my job because I'll make 12 people happy and all the rest of you upset. So I'm not going to do that. But I'm going to sit down and I'm going to sign this. And I guess we can have the students. Now, why are you all sitting up? Did they not have any seats for you down here? Why are you all up here? They just chose you as props. One from each city? Okay, let's go real quick.
My name is Asia, and I'm from Winthrop.
My name is Natalie, and I'm from Zeller City.
My name is Caitlin, and I'm from Castor.
My name is Taylor, and I'm from Flower.
My name is Emma, and I'm from Bombay.
My name is also Taylor, and I'm from Taft.
My name is Kirsten, and I'm from Hobart.
My name is Lincoln, and I'm from Davidson.
My name is Sam, and I'm from Montgomery.
My name is Sonia West, and I am from Marriott City, I'm just kidding.
My name is Leanne Smithley, and I'm from Stowe City.
My name is Lindsay Breslin, and I'm from Deal City.
My name is Julia Calderon, and I'm from Allen City.
My name is Molly, and I'm from Yummy.
My name is Dustin, and I'm from Devo.
My name is Adam, and I'm from Jones City.
My name is Amber, and I'm from Hayes.
My name is Claire, and I'm from Stoy.
My name is Caitlin, and I'm from Rice City.
My name is Ariana, and I'm from O'Connor.
And my name is John Kasich. I live in Westerville. Oh. I have to tell you that this was really fun. Did you learn anything from what I said today? I mean, seriously. I want you to do well. You know, I kind of look at all of you, and I have such hope for you. You know, I want you to be what you want to be. So, Good luck, God bless you, and I'll see you around Ohio. Thank you.